In Proverbs chapter 10, verse 22. What is blessing? Blessing is a supernatural reward from God. A supernatural reward from God is blessing. When God rewards you supernaturally, people can reward you naturally. Award is different from reward. People give award, God gives reward. Sometimes you do good for people, they don't even remember you, but God remembers you. God can never forget you. Every good you are doing, God is recording it. God is recording it. The day you did it, the time you did it, the month you did it, the year you did it, the age you did it, God is recording it. One day the book of remembrance will be open and your name will appear. And God will say, let us lift this man and promote this man. Remember Mordecai. He did good for the king and he saved the life of the king, and they forgot about him, but they put it in the book. They threw him away, but the book was not thrown away. They disqualified him, but in the book he was qualified. I prophesy on you today. Maybe somebody say you are not qualified for that job. I speak over you. The God of heaven shall qualify you. The power of the Holy Ghost shall qualify you. If you believe it, touch your neighbor and say, I'm not talking to somebody here. Mordecai, his book of remembrance was open. And they say, what has been done for this man that helped the king? They said nothing. They said, go and prepare a donkey. Prepare the clothes. Prepare the royal robe and give to him. There's somebody hearing the sound of my voice. Do not, this morning, in the name that is above every other name, anybody you have helped that has forgotten you, anybody you have supported that has forgotten you, in 72 hours from now, they will call you on your cell phone. They will send an email to you. They will send a text to you. God will use them to promote you. God will use them to favor you. God will use them to lift you and to take you to the next level of your life. If you believe it, clap your hand and say, fire! Blessing is a supernatural reward from God. Number two, meaning of blessing, a divine pronouncement that nobody can revoke. A divine pronouncement on your life that nobody can revoke. They can revoke a lot of things, but they can't revoke the God's blessings upon your life. You remember Balaam and Balak? Balak hired Balaam to go and curse the people of God. And by the time he got there in the book of Numbers, chapter 22 and 23, he got there, he wanted to curse. As he opened his mouth, God made him a stammerer. And after he released his tongue, he said, I bless you. Balak was angry. He said, why did you curse the people? And why did you bless the people I wanted you to curse? He did it the second time, blessing. He did it the third time, blessing. He did it the fourth time, blessing. He did it the fifth time, blessing. He did it the sixth time, blessing. He did it the seventh time, blessing. Then Balaam said, don't bless them. Don't curse them. Leave them. He said, how shall I curse whom the Lord has blessed? I prophesy on you. There is no more curse on your life. I say, you are blessed. You are blessed in the city. You are blessed when you go out. You are blessed when you sit down. You are blessed when you rise. You are blessed in your office. You are blessed in your profession. You are blessed in your career. Somebody make a joyful noise and say, I'm blessed. Touch your neighbor, say, I'm blessed, I'm blessed, I'm blessed. I'm blessed, I'm blessed, I'm blessed, I'm blessed, I'm blessed. I'm blessed, I'm blessed, I'm blessed, I'm blessed. You may not like me, but I'm blessed. You may not like my face, but I'm blessed. You may not like the way I talk, but I'm blessed. You may not like my style, I'm blessed. You may not like my stature, but I am blessed. You can't deny it. You can't argue it. You can't stop me. I'm short, I'm blessed. Even if I'm short, I am blessed. I am tall, I am blessed. It does not matter my height. It does not matter my size. It does not matter my weight. I am blessed. When God wants to bless a man, he does not look at his foundation. He does not look at his background. He does not look at his color. He does not look at his ways. He does not look at his educational background. When God wants to bless a man, he pick anybody and bless. That's why he can make a nobody to become somebody. He can make nothing to become something. A useless person can become a product of Kabashia. You have gone through some things, but God said he's going to fix it for you. He said, I'm the God of all flesh. Nothing is too hard for me to do. They've said all manner of things against you. They've done all manner of things against you, but God said, I'm going to turn it for your good. I'm going to turn it for your lifting. I'm going to turn it for your favor. I will turn it for your promotion. I will turn it around and set you on the solid rock. The time has come. You are moving out of the dry season. You are moving out of the dry season to your new season. Your new season of blessing. Your new season of favor. Your new season of grace. Let it come upon you.